three new IEMs to unbox and talk about today. We have the U-Mate 2, we have the Aiko OH5 Asgard, and of course, the title, Hexa. Hey friends, welcome back to NFL on Kids Audio. Like I said, we have a lot of new IEMs to unbox and talk about today. Let's start off with Hexa, the one that's been hyped and talked about for the past couple of weeks. Is this the new $100 king? We'll find out now. Here's the front of the box, so you can see the anime girl there. Her name is actually Virgo, fun fact for those of you who didn't know. Here's the back of the box with more information and the graph. Here's how the inner box looks. Here's the inside of the box, so you can see the IEMs are right there, and this little pouch here has the cable. Removing the pouch reveals sets of tips. Yes, quite a few of them. Here's the carrying pouch up close, and it is a softer carrying pouch. Please, IEM brands, make more softer cases. No more hard case. I don't think a lot of people actually use those. The cables are exactly the same as the Zero, if I'm not mistaken. So if you're familiar with the Zero, you're getting the exact same thing. Now, truth be told, this is not really a true first impression because I did open these up to graph them and I also listened to them for a little bit because, you know, I was curious because of all the raving reviews out there. I had to put my ears on it right away after graphing, but I didn't listen to him for so long, so let's quickly refresh the memory and talk about it. Now, I do have my nitpicks. The tuning on it is not my personal favorite, but all the nitpicks that I have for it, and I felt the same when I first listened to this as well, is not a nitpick that is warranted for IEMs under $100. These kind of nitpicks that I'm about to tell you is more so if this costs $150, $200, or even a little bit more than that. Pretty much a more mainstream sounding Blessing 2 by Moondrop. So if you're familiar with Blessing 2 by Moondrop, it doesn't really have a lot of bass. It's a lot more focused on the upper mid-range and the treble frequencies. The Blessing 2 comes across just more intense and a little bit too fatiguing to listen to at times. For me, I much prefer the Dust version if you're talking about the Blessing 2 twins. The Hexa takes the Blessing 2's DNA and kind of makes it more palatable. They added more bass, which balanced out the bit of energy in the upper mid range and the treble area. Female vocals still comes across not the smoothest though. Same problem with the Blessing 2, is that it has just a little bit too much intensity in the treble area, if you will. So the timbre comes across just a little bit scratchy and peaky. Not an IEM that I personally would listen to for a long period of time. And I felt this way when I first listened to it, is that I quickly became fatigued. Like after a good 20, 30 minutes or so, I start to want to turn down the volume. Technical abilities, details, I would say the Hexa is really competent for the price. I find it hard to find a true competition in details to the Hexa, aside from Dioko. That one has quite a lot of details as well. Both of those are right now the current king of details for IEMs under $100. Needless to say though, when it comes to Hexa as a package, as a whole, in competition with the other IEMs on the market within the same price range, the Hexa easily sits amongst the top three, and for some top five, or even number one for some of you guys out there. Now, in comparison to like the Aria, the Titan S, the Tim T3 Plus, the tuning is going to be quite different, and you might prefer the tuning on the Aria and Titan S more so than on the Hexa. Again, if you're really sensitive to the upper frequencies, then the Hexa might be too intense for you. Thus, the Aria and the Titan S still both have their own market. It sounds smoother, it's easier to listen to, not as detailed or as well extending as the Hexa, but at the end of the day, they're much easier to listen to for long listening session while still being well tuned in their own rights. All that being said, Hexa, I am impressed by it. If you like a more intense tuning, upper mid-range and treble focus tuning, and good details, then you'll go for the Hexa. For $80, I think is an absolute steal. But if you're sensitive to treble in any way at all, I would suggest try demoing this before you purchase because it might not be the safest choice for you. And it goes without saying as well, if you're a bass lover, that's not for you. Next, let's talk about Aiko Asgard OH5. This gigantron of a box right here. Uber massive. Unnecessary? Maybe. Really cool? I guess so. So here's how the inner box looks, and you open it like so. Very extravagant. You can tell already by watching this unboxing that it's not gonna be a cheap IM just by the unboxing experience. And look at that, the IM sits inside like so. And the box also has a drawer. The carrying case and tips. Now the carrying case here is really heavy duty. It's big as well. Like, I would never use this personally because it is just massive. It's bigger than my phone. The inside of it though holds the cable, and this cable is heavy duty cable. Like, it feels premium. It's a little rubbery, sure, just a tad, but it's built like a tank. And not only are the cables heavy duty, the IMs are as well. Just a super well constructed product in general. First thing I hear is an overwhelming sense of warmth and bass bleed, and my female vocals sound husky. They sound not natural. Aiko, I love everything you did with this product. I love the build, I love the box, I love everything. But you need to figure out the tuning department for your IMs. The rest of it, I love. And last but not least, we have the U-Make 2. Yes, this is another sequel to the U-Make collection. We have the original U-Make, the U-Make Midnight, and now the U-Make 2. Here's the back of the box with more information and the graph. Here's what it looks like on the inside. We have the IEMs, we have the tips, and the case which holds the cable inside. Here's the case up close, nice. Opens up like so. Cable inside. Now, to my knowledge, I think this looks similar to the cable that you get with the Midnight. Now, some backstory in regards to the U-Make. The original one I really love. It's one of my most favorite IEMs of the time that I tried it. The U-Make Midnight is a good improvement over the original in details especially. And now the U-Make 2 is said to be even better than the Midnight as advertised by C-Audio themselves. So we shall see. I like this. This is good. It does have quite a bit of treble energy, and the female vocals extension region is quite energetic as well, and it might be too much for some. But all in all, is well tuned, well balanced. There's good bass, there's good energy, there's good extension. Vocals sound natural for the most part, if not a little bit on the thin side. Details are also quite nice. $200, same price as the Midnight. I think it's just as worth it as the Midnight. But in terms of which one I prefer, I need to AB. All right, that is it for this video today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will be reviewing the U-Make 2 at a later date, the OH5 Asgard, probably not the Hexa. I don't think I need to review the Hexa anymore because I kind of gave a big spiel about it throughout, you know, the beginning of the video. You guys can already, you know, make a purchase decision based on what I said at the beginning of the video, so I don't think I need to review it. But yes, U-Make 2 review coming in the near future. Hexa is good, U-Make 2 is good, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out, bye.